Welcome to Freedom Church.
You're about to watch our podcast. If you...
We'd love to connect with you.
And send you a gift. So text that number down below.
Oh, it's so cold.
Freedom Church.
Happy Sunday. It is the day after Christmas, and as you can tell, we are not at the Freedom Center. We have a very special service for you and your family to enjoy today.
Wherever you're watching today, it's an honor to do church together. I hope that this is a special service for you, whether you're like at home with your kids on the couch, or maybe you're cuddled up in bed watching this on Apple TV, but wherever you are, let's have church. It's going to be a special service.
Yep.
We want to introduce you to our family. We want to introduce you to a new member of our family.
This is true.
and hopefully we'll leave you with some practical things over this next week as we're all preparing to enter into a new year together.
Yep.
Some things from the Word of God that I know that God has for your heart and for your family this year. So I want to invite my family. Logan, come over here. Bring your sled. Carter, come over here. I want you guys to open up the service by reading a scripture.
Come here, buddy.
So I want you to read this. The mic's got to hear you on my shirt here, so here we go.
The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field.
All right, I'm going to see you just hit the slope right here with the sled.
Bye.
Hit it.
Bye.
All right, can you read right there, Carter, from verse 45?
Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it.
Awesome.
All right.
Now show your brother really how to sled. Okay.
Let's do it.
This is from Matthew chapter 13, and it's two parables that Jesus tells back to back. What's the big idea of this parable?
The big idea. Really is that nothing of value comes without a sacrifice.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So he's saying once upon a time there was a guy who found a pearl that was so big that he was willing to sell everything that he had to go get this pearl. So if he trades in everything, he can have the one pearl, but the one pearl is worth everything. So it's a great sacrifice.
It's worth more than everything that he owns.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's the story about the treasure?
Same thing, that everything that this man owned wasn't worth what that treasure was worth. And so he sold all of his stuff for that one treasure.
I'm gonna go buy this field, so now that I own the field, I can own the treasure that's in the field.
Right.
It's a little bit sneaky when you think about it. It's a little bit sneaky. But he's thinking, I'm gonna be resourceful. Whatever it takes to get this treasure. The treasure that Jesus is talking about is, of course, the kingdom of heaven or eternal life, another way that it's a relationship with God from now into eternity. That's what he's talking about. He's saying, you know, if it's possible to know God, then everything we have in life is worth sacrificing for something that has such unbelievable value.
So good. Okay, so we want to introduce you to a new member of the Coleman household. No, I am not pregnant and we did not adopt.
Kendall.
But we do have a new member.
Here, why don't you hold this?
Okay.
So this is our daughter, Kendall. She's 7 years old.
She's six.
Okay, she's six, but she will be seven. And this is, tell everybody,
who's this? Mojo. This is Mojo. Freedom Church, meet Mojo.
I just imagine there's like at least a couple kids watching right now who are saying, this is exactly why I'm paying attention. What's your favorite thing about Mojo?
That he's so kind.
He's so kind.
All right.
All right.
All right. No one's going to pay attention to the Word of God if we leave this beautiful place on there. The reason why I wanted to introduce you to Mojo is not just because kids are watching, but because, you know, getting a dog for our family we knew was going to be a whole different level of responsibility. How long had they been asking for a dog?
For years.
Yeah.
I mean, I told them we'd never have a dog. I'm not much of an animal person and I'm allergic to all dogs. So this was a huge life-changing sacrifice for me.
And it would be a sacrifice for everybody. But here's what we know, and this is how I tie this kind of into the scripture, is that like you so eloquently summarized a minute ago, you know, everything that's valuable in life comes at a sacrifice.
Yeah.
And so I knew the dog was gonna be a sacrifice. You knew the dog was gonna be a sacrifice.
Yep.
We tried to tell the kids it was gonna be a sacrifice, but it probably wasn't until they were picking up poop, trying to like potty train this thing.
Yep.
The dog's yapping all night and they're not sleeping. It's, we knew that stuff was gonna come. We knew it would be a sacrifice. They didn't. But I know looking back on it, as this dog has brought more love to our family, that, and we do joke like it's a new member of the family, but
right.
but really everything that's valuable right. comes at a sacrifice. And this morning, Kendall, I didn't even tell you, but she was like, I don't even mind picking up the poop. That's what she told me. She's like,
she's
I don't
even
mind.
She's almost excited when it happens.
So draw that connection to your own life.
Yeah.
Try to understand what Jesus is saying here practically. There are things that he has for you that he wants you to know him in different ways. He has a purpose for your life yeah. that is in 2022 that you don't even haven't even seen those purposes
right.
yet. There's a depth of relationship with him. There's love and peace and all sorts of things that are coming your way that I know God has in store for you.
So true.
But Jesus is clear when he says, like, some of these things that you're going to inherit, the only way there is to decide now I'm willing to make a sacrifice
yeah.
so that I can receive these things that have such great value. Ultimately, the thing that has the most value is our relationship with God.
100%.
You know, God made a great sacrifice for you. In order for you to have a relationship with him, the Father sacrificed his Son. The Son understood what he was doing.
Yeah.
It's not like the Father said, hey, I'm sending you to the cross and you didn't sign up for this. Jesus in heaven co-conspired with God,
yeah.
the Father and the Holy Spirit. And he said, I will willingly lay down my life. We read him say, I will lay down my life only to pick it back up. He makes a sacrifice for you because to heaven, to God, to the Father, you are the greatest value. And he would lay his life down
yeah.
if that's what it takes. He would make a sacrifice if that's what it means to have a relationship with you.
Matthew 19, Jesus talks again about a sacrifice. Verse 16 says, then a man came to Jesus and asked, teacher, what good thing must I do to get eternal life? Why do you ask me about what is good? Jesus replied, there is only one who is good. If you want to enter life, keep the commandments. Which one? He inquired. Jesus replied, you shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not give false testimony. Honor your father and mother and love your neighbor as yourself. All of these I have kept, the young man asked. What do I still lack? Jesus answered, if you want to be perfect, go sell your possessions and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me.
A lot of times people refer to this passage as the rich young ruler because I mean, that's really what everybody wants, right? They want to be rich, they want to be young, and they want to rule, right? So we have this story where Jesus is talking to a guy who essentially has everything that is considered great value
right.
in our world today.
Mm-hmm.
And he has it all, and yet he's still left empty. He hears about Jesus, and he hears about the possibility of the Messiah, and so he says, good teacher. And then Jesus immediately goes like, hey, did you want to talk to me because I'm a good teacher? Or do you want to talk to me because I'm the God teacher? You know, that's just like, why do you call me good? Because only God is good.
Yeah.
Because Jesus knows his heart. So that's why he's asking him that.
Right.
And then they had this conversation and you read it perfectly. He's just saying like, you know, I've done the not kill people thing. I've
right.
done the not commit adultery thing. I'm doing the things that the Bible says actually bring a better way of life. Yet here I am today asking, is there something more? And is there something more I can trade in or sacrifice?
Yeah.
Because a man who's rich and rules knows that everything that he has already came at a sacrifice. So he's like, the kingdom of God, the principle is going to be the same. And Jesus essentially says what? Oh, well, then just trade in more. What do you have left to trade in? Why don't you trade in everything and then you'll get, I mean, essentially everything in return. And I don't really know what he was thinking. I don't know if he's like, well, I don't know if it's not worth it, or I don't know if I don't trust Jesus, or man, it took so much sacrifice to get this. But obviously he's sad about it
mm-hmm.
because it says he walks away sad.
So when I read this story, I'm reminded of the first time we took our firstborn Logan, who you just met a minute ago, to Chuck E. Cheese. I think he was about 3 years old and it was his first trip. And he just saw all the games and that was exciting. But then he began to understand as we played that when he won, he got tickets.
Right.
And you know, it's his first time at Chuck E. Cheese. He's not a baller. He's not like a ski ball master yet.
He wasn't doing the basketball shots for sure.
He's getting like one ticket at a time. Right. But then there was this moment where the manager came over and he was just making sure no one was there.
I totally
remember
this.
He was just checking all the machines, making sure they were feeding properly. And he came over to Logan and gave him like massive amounts of tickets.
I'm not exaggerating, hundreds.
Hundreds. And we thought like, whoa, that's so generous, thank you. But then he did it at every stop, like every game, he just began to gift Logan with hundreds and hundreds of these tickets. And Logan
was stoked. He's like 3 years old, carrying a pile of tickets like up to his chin.
Yeah, I mean, he's dropping them. It's massive. I mean, this feels like the best day of his entire life. And so it's just tickets and tickets and tickets. And then I go, okay, Logan, let's go turn in the tickets. And he was like, no!
Yeah.
My tickets! And I was like, yeah, but the tickets are so you can get a prize. And he was like, no! My tickets! He was just so excited about the amount of tickets he had. And he didn't understand that he could trade those in for a much greater prize. And so when I hear these stories in the Bible about this parable and this story about the rich young ruler, I think so many times we get distracted or we're so excited about the amount of tickets or how much resource and time and effort things took that we hold on to them instead of exchanging them in for what God has for us.
I mean, he's 3 years old. He's never been to Chuck E. Cheese. He's excited for the tickets, but he's never seen behind the counter, so he doesn't know the prizes. So not only that, I don't think at 3 years old, he doesn't have a concept of redemption.
Right.
Because that's what redemption is you trade something in, something is purchased, right?
Yeah,
so you exchange real money for Chuck E. Cheese coins. Chuck E. Cheese coins then become tickets. The tickets are redeemed for the prize. And that's kind of, this sounds totally cheesy and corny, but that's what Jesus did. Jesus became a Chuck E. Cheese coin for us. So that he could, in the incarnation, Jesus becomes who he needs to be to meet us where we are. This is Christ coming as Jesus. Mm-hmm. And then he gives his life for us. And then, you know, the more I think about it, you know, our Heavenly Father is the one giving us the tickets. He's doing everything for us. The more I think about this illustration, the more it makes sense. It's not like Logan even earned those tickets to begin with.
Right.
It's just grace on top of grace. And then here we are. And we're seeing tickets, we're seeing Jesus, but we are not seeing everything behind the counter. We're not seeing heaven yet.
Right.
And that's such a great example because like the rich young ruler, all he can see is what he has. And then Jesus is inviting him to trust him. If you can trust the God that lives for you and dies for you and raises for you, if you can trust him with your life, I can promise you that there is so much behind the counter.
Yeah.
God has love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, self-control. And I'm pretty sure this is not a story about a rich young ruler who God just wanted him to be poor.
Right.
Because something admirable about being poor. He's saying these possessions have actually possessed you. So you're gonna have to let go of this in order to make room for what I have for you. And so maybe rather than seeing the rich young ruler as a story about how to be more generous,
right,
what is it that's in your hands? What is it that you're holding on to that you're focused on? But if you can lift your eyes to the one who loves you so much, who's given you every reason to trust him, if you're willing to sacrifice, there is a great pearl of great price. There's a field with the treasure. There's so much more that he has for you in 2022. So our prayer for you is what?
Is that you would figure out today with, maybe it's a conversation with a loved one, maybe it's just in your own heart right now, that you begin to ask God, what could I give back to you that maybe has been something I've sacrificed for, I've worked hard for, that could be time, that could be resources, it could be anything, but ask the Holy Spirit right now, God, what is it that you want me to give back to you so that you can bless it, but that you can have all of me as we enter 2022?
Trade in all the tickets. Don't hold part of the tickets back.
So good.
Because every ticket you trade in, don't hold back some of what you have. Trade in the whole pearl, buy the whole field. The message is everything goes in. everything, just like Jesus laid down everything of who he was. God did not hold back from us. One of my favorite verses is Romans 8. If God would not hold back his son from you, what would he ever hold back?
Yeah.
Don't hold back from God. Ask the Holy Spirit to show you what requires a sacrifice in your life so that you can have more of God. Will you pray for anybody who's watching right now? Maybe it's a kid who's sitting on the couch or in bed with mom and dad, or maybe somebody driving in the car watching this on YouTube.
Absolutely. Do you bow your heads with me, I guess, or you can watch me
pray. If you're
driving,
do not bow your head. If you're driving, do not do that.
God, we love you so much.
Yes.
And Lord, I know that you're a God that's so big that you can meet every single person that's watching this live or watching this years to come on YouTube. God, I pray that your Holy Spirit would begin to speak to our hearts and give us direction, give us vision, excite us about the year that's ahead, that you would help us assess our life.
Yeah.
and sift out the things that maybe don't need to be there, but more importantly, the things that we can give to you. Jesus, we need your direction. We want your direction, Lord. And we pray that you would do that today in us so that we can be ready as we enter a new year together with you as our focus, you as our prize. And we love you so much. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In a moment here, our worship team has actually prepared a couple worship songs that they wrote for your family to enjoy and to respond in worship. It's always appropriate to, after hearing the word of God, to respond in worship.
Yes.
It's usually in those moments that God says, oh, here's how I'm, you know, being the rich young ruler, or here's my pearl of great price, or the, you know, so that will happen as you worship him. But before we even do that, if you're watching right now and you have never given your life to Christ,
yeah.
Though the Freedom Center is closed today, our worship team is not. our prayer team is not. Our prayer team is actually online live right now. And if you have something that you need prayer for, please put that in the chat or click that prayer button so that we can partner with you in prayer. We love you. And even though we're not having church at the Freedom Center, we're still having church.
Yeah.
And we still want to make sure that we're there with you. And if you've never given your life to Jesus, what better day to give your life to Jesus than this last Sunday of the year?
Yep.
It's the last Sunday of the year. Next week we have baptisms. This would be a great time for you to say, you know what? I do not want to go into 2022 not knowing my Savior.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants you to know him. He wants you to be known by him. So if that's you and you're saying, I need a Savior, in the chat that's right in front of you, just type, I believe. And that right there is the confession of your mouth. Romans 10:9 said that if we confess with our mouth and believe with our heart that Jesus is Lord, you can be saved. And I know that there is a God who loves you and wants a relationship with you. And the faster we realize that we need him and admit it, the sooner he comes running into our life. So, hey, we love you. Anything else you want to add?
Let's worship Jesus together.
Thank you. Chains are breaking, lives are changing, God is on the move. Hope is rising, miracles can happen, God is on the move. Chains are breaking, lives are changing, God is on the move.
Freedom Church, can we come together and celebrate the fact that God is on the move? He's on the move in our church. He's on the move in your life.
Yes, and if you made that decision today to follow Jesus, we are celebrating with you right now. We're so excited for this next step in your faith. We have a prayer team ready to pray with you and help guide you in this. And we want to send you a free Bible. Yeah, so go ahead and text that number down below. We can't wait to partner with you.
Speaking of those next steps, next Sunday, we actually have live baptisms happening. Don't let anything hold you back from going public with your faith. Church Online, this is for you too. We don't want you to think that you're alone. We want to make this happen wherever you're at. So let's go public together next week.
Let's do it.
We love you, Freedom Church.